There is no denying that J.K. Rowling is one of the greatest storytellers ever to have walked our wonderful planet. But Joe, I've got questions. Hey guys, my name is Sucharita, this is Film Companion, you are watching Not A Movie Review, and right now I am not going to be reviewing Fantastic Beasts, Crimes of Grindelwald. The film starts in New York, year is 1927. Grindelwald is a prisoner at the Magical Congress of the United States of America, or MACUSA. He's danger AF, so full protection mein usko kahin to transfer karne ki taiyari hai. Lekin obviously, because he is Grindelwald and the film is going to be about his crimes, he escapes and starts amassing followers to take over the world. Kyunki evil villain type wahi karte hain. Newt is back home in London, jahan us par travel ban laga hua hai kyunki New York mein usne macha diya tha pichle saal in the last film. His brother is a high-ranking auror and is trying to convince him to join the ministry with all his talents. Lekin Newt is also like Bunny from Ye Jawani Hai Diwani. Main udna chahta hun, daudna chahta hun type. The nomad Jacob is also back as our sisters Tina and Queenie. और इन सभी के रास्ते जा रहे हैं पेरिस की तरफ क्योंकि क्रीडेंस वहां है और सबको चाहिए. कौन क्रीडेंस? Remember the obscurial from the last film? The kid adopted by the crazy lady from Salem who turns out has a shit ton of magic inside him? Yeah, so last movie ke end mein, it was made kind of clear in a big way ki Credence to gayo. So how is it that he's back? We are told he managed to survive, but how? No explanation is given. He's in search of his true family and we're in search of many, many things. Standalone film to dekho, ye nahi hai. Pichli movie agar aapne bahut hi dhyan se nahi dekhi hai recently, this might make little to no sense to you. So my suggestion would be, 120 rupay dekar YouTube पे ऑफिशियली पुरानी फिल्म देख लीजिए, रिफ्रेश करके फिर तब जाना. Netflix पर भी आई एम बीइंग टोल्ड. Even for a hardcore obsessive fan like me, there is so much new stuff going on, it became difficult to keep track. So many questions. क्योंकि कोई किताब पे ये बेस्ड नहीं है, कोई बैकग्राउंड नहीं हमें मालूम है, तो टू अ ह्यूज एक्सटेंट इवन फैंस आर गोइंग इन विदाउट मच इन्फॉर्मेशन. और अभी ना मार्वल यूनिवर्स की तरह ये टाइमलाइन भी काफी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड हो रही है. सी, दिस इज इन 1927, यानी कि वन ईयर आफ्टर वोल्डेमोर्ट इज बॉर्न, वो 1926 में पैदा हुआ था, ठीक है. लेकिन नगीनी इज इन दिस फिल्म, इस वक्त अच्छी खासी अडल्ट औरत है. हाँ, मोर ऑन नगीनी लेटर. Which means Nagini the snake is actually older than Voldy when we meet him years later with Harry Potter. Lekin also Professor McGonagall. Basis many calculations and fan theories etc. which have been proved and confirmed, McGonagall was younger than Voldemort, even though movies mein she looks older because of the casting choice, I guess. So born in 1935, how is she a teacher at Hogwarts in 1927? And also in a flashback sequence before 1927. There is new wandless magic also at full display. Newt has some kind of device which lets him recreate old magical scenes. His wand turns into a hearing device. And if you were pissed off how Death Eaters were shown flying in the Harry Potter movies when they aren't supposed to be able to do that at all, here Grindelwald supporters are giant black curtain types just rising up from the ground, and while it's great to look at, it's not fun to try and comprehend. Do you see where I'm going with this? Abhi to maine spoilers ki baat kari bhi nahi hai. Agar hum movie ke twists aur reveals pe aa jaye na, to karenge baad mein kabhi. Now, let's just talk about Nagini. She's a hella important character. Bandi Voldemort ki horcrux hai, jisko Neville Longbottom kills and turns into an instant badass. But here, she doesn't serve any purpose. Kyun aap itne sahi character ko aisi detailed backstory de rahe ho that she's actually a maledictus from Indonesia? Manji, she has a blood curse where one day she will turn into the snake entirely and not be able to return to her human form. You establish her relationship with Credence, who she meets at a circus in Paris, but her character goes from there to nowhere. In fact, this scene from the teaser trailer where she finds out what Credence actually is just not there in the film. You know, makes you think that her portions have been massively cut out, which is just disappointing. Same goes for Leta Lestrange, played by Zoe Kravitz, a character that was teased in the last film, exciting for two reasons, because she's Newt's love interest and she's a Lestrange, a notoriously evil visiting family. Again, she has barely anything to do in the film, except narrate a story at one point which conveniently ties her to people Newt had met in America on his last trip, which just makes it too much of a coincidence, convenient. Another girl, Bunty, who gets a lovely introduction moment. She helps Newt with taking care of all his beasts at home, clearly is in love with him, she makes eyes at him constantly, flirts, and then disappears, not to be seen or heard from throughout. See, while it is really fun to go into this world and experience the magic, I can't help but dissect it. Kyunki 13 saal ki thi jab se this universe has been a part of mine. Isliye from a fan's point of view, it's disappointing ki director David Yates and writer J.K. Rowling are going itna zyada haywire without too much explanation given to us. Mirror of Erised and Bogart also make an appearance from the original universe, uske bare mein bhi baad mein baat karenge. Hogwarts bhi zyada dikhaya nahi hai, so if you're going with hopes that action is going to happen on the school grounds, don't. Eddie Redmayne is excellent as Newt, bringing his own physicality into the character as per usual. Jude Law as Albus Dumbledore is the perfect casting choice kyunki wo dekhne mein bahut hot hai, and imagine a young Albus to be quite the stunner. Johnny Depp though, super actor, sure, but we've seen him do this kind of mad person role way too many times, and now I don't know how well that works here. Not entirely convinced, not gonna lie. Special shout out to Ezra Miller for being amazing and hot and just perfect in every sense of the word. But you mustn't miss the film if you're a fan of the universe and this kind of storytelling in general. It's a fun time at the movies. Music, set design, costumes, magic, all the ingredients are there to make it a fun couple of hours. But Joe, I got questions. So on a scale of 1 to 10, Fantastic Beasts, Crimes of Grindelwald is 20s ka Paris dekhne milega, if nothing else, kaafi sundar hai. Do lambe videos hain this week. You saw the other one? Bohemian Rhapsody? Subscribe kar lo, miss nahi hona chahiye.